So thank you very much for the kind words, and Mr. Kuba ji, Vartika Shukla ji, and a very, very well chosen group of panelists who will shape the industry in the future. The Indian industry has worked very, and actually all over the world, has worked very hard to be the corporate steward that our society needs. Now, the Indian industry has always had to deal with very expensive capital compared to other places in the world. And we have focused over in the last 30 years since the 1990s on value engineering instead of just taking up hasty opportunities. Now, that's because we respect the sector. We respect what it means. We respect what can happen when things go wrong. But money is sector agnostic. Money doesn't care what sector. Money goes after returns. Now, suddenly what has happened is that Indian and foreign money has been flowing into the chemical industry, where all of us, if not all of us, were, you know, in public companies, were dealing with single digit PE multiples. Now, many of us are in double digit, and in some cases, very high double digit. So the questions that we get asked when we're talking to analysts and funds and all of these things is, what is your return on assets? What is the contribution margin going to be? Quarter on quarter results, will it be sustainable? Those questions. Now, this rarely will encourage players to invest in the important levers which are going to take us not just over the next quarter or the next year, but the next 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, which is infrastructure, safety, sustainability. And a lot of times, this is going to be an area which, if left unattended, is going to become not just a bottleneck, but it is going to become a major headache. And God forbid it becomes a situation where it leads to a catastrophe. But it needs to be done. It's not easy to invest in this. It is not easy to choose to invest in something which is not going to give the growth when everybody is asking for the growth. It's like going to a charity and giving money there, then finding out that they took that money and bought more computers. It may have been helpful, but this is not why you gave the money to the charity. So it is not an easy decision to take, but it is imperative for us, because this is where the government can also encourage quality growth. It can give a priority to companies that have demonstrated a track record for good governance, safety, and sustainability. That in the last few years, there has not been a single quarter where the beginning and the end of the quarter was not drastically different. You've had quarters that started on a high and ended on a low. You've had quarters that started on a low and then completely on a high. And all of these times, what we are seeing is that the companies that have been able to show steady and sustainable gains over mercurial gains have been the ones who have benefited in the medium and long term. There will always be opportunities that are, flavor of the season. Here and now, it is a fantastic opportunity to get into a product, to get into a sector. But we need to think about the impact in the long term. I'm really happy to hear all of the other panelists, whether it is Maulik Patel or whether it is Kapil Malhotra or Tikuji, all of them have said that investing in the basics, investing in infrastructure will really help to take our resource security to the next level. It's about growth, but it is also about making sure that the growth keeps on coming. Now, investing to take advantage of short-term opportunities may take us to the big league in the next 5 years, But then they also have the risk of pulling us down. Investing in quality, infrastructure, safety, and sustainability will definitely take us to the big league, but it'll take 7 to 10 years. Now, it is for the industry, the government policymakers, and the kind of capital and the investment that is coming in to decide whether we invest to grow faster in a short period of time in a mercurial manner, or invest to grow in the long term, but in a safe and sustainable manner. I think between all of the panelists here, we are very clear that the growth should be one which is at the very worst balanced, or at least, more biased towards ensuring that there is good quality growth. And with hearing that, I am extremely encouraged. Thank you for this opportunity.